That is a good church. What makes a good church? Maybe you can go to its theology. I'm putting a good church is something which affirms the 5 points. You know, the 5 points of Tulip, they affirm it, they affirm sola dea gloria. That's a good church. That is the basis of a good church. A good church is a one which has a worship team that is strong and powerful. Resonates in my spirit. Is that how I measure a good church? Do I measure a good church by how they give to the poor? Maybe. All of these things, some of which are good and some of which are bad, I see it in churches. Surely, there are good churches which do all of these things. But what really can I say in one line? Would I say this makes a good church? So now our reading today will be in Colossians chapter 2. Colossians chapter 2 from verse 16. But when I found Bazalwane, I'd like to just get into that money about Ibandla laseKolose. Ibandla laseKolose is a peculiar church. It's alifani njengebandla laseKorinthe or Ibandla laseEfeso. I'd find it in a few respects. Ibandla laseKorinthe nebandla laseEfeso, they had actual visitations from apostles. There was actual apostles which went to those churches. Ibandla lakhona laseKolose, I never actually heard in recorded history where khona bekufika Apostle Paul and preach there. I was actually shocked to find that out. My pen has nemephi eBhayibheli la kusho ukutshengisa khona i-trip kaPaul looking ukuthi no, can't be, he wrote an entire book to this church but never actually went there. Then I went back and I found impela it's not there. It's one of those churches that never got a visitation. So that is the first thing about them. And they were placed in what is called Southeast Turkey. Currently Southeast Turkey, what was called back in the days Asia. And interbalegile ngalokhu is ukuthi it was a very, very distant place from Jerusalem. Meaning ukuthi aba Judah were most likely zero to none. There was no Jewish people there. So if you look at indlela Paul used to go into amabandla, if you look at Acts, used to go to the synagogue, preach to the synagogue, get a few people saved there, then come out and then preach to the flock, which was normally indlela akadenza ngayo. But in this situation, in Colossae, it would have been really difficult to have done that. So it's another thing, it's pointed about the church in Colossae. The church in Colossae did not have a Jewish background. They did not have a background where you can say, "Uti men figa gizokala ngithi gizokala from the Old Testament," because amaJuda bebanayo le nto ukuthi the Old Testament besimazi uNkulunkulu, and abantu abaphila ine amongst nabo bekambona ukuthi khona lo muntu ohlukile walaba abantu. Ukhona lo muntu ohlukile laba abantu. So bebazobona ukuthi oh, lo muntu akafiki nento entsha. It's not very edgy with culture. It's calling the shugin. The Jewish life that they would have lived would have played a role in the evangelical work, but it wasn't there in the church of Colossae. In Colossae, there was none of this. In Colossae, it was unlikely because it was 1,400 kilometers away from Jerusalem. Now, knowing Jewish custom, umele ukuthi every Jewish man is supposed to appear three times in Jerusalem. So it would have been extremely difficult if there was a Jewish community there for them to travel 1,400 kilometers. It's a very far distance. From here to Debe is about 96 kilometers. So ungayicabanga leyo nto umJuda ezofuna ukuhlala so far away from Jerusalem. It would have been impractical for amaJuda ukuthi ahlale khona eColosse. So now this is a place with almost no, where Christ has not been named. But there was something that was named in that place. It was mysticism. We check in the Old Testament, and not in the Old Testament, in church history, we are going to put ibandla laseColosse was truly without any form of izinto that could point them to Christ. There was nothing beforehand, there was nothing pointing them to Christ. Well, but in the church of Colossae, we had this indefinite mysticism. In mysticism, just with Kaza Kabanzi, is to believe that Kona is mysterious knowledge. To believe that Jebasi Kona, there'll be some pagan worshippers. And ama pagan abantu abangakholwa abangamazi uNkulunkulu bebekhona ukuthi khona izinto okumele ngizenze ukuze ngithole ulwazi thizeni ngoNkulunkulu olozophelisa uqeliza usindisa. Bekumele ngithole ulwazi thizeni from other places, whether ngiyahlaba, whether ngishisa impepho, whether ngenza iritual, ngenza something ezoba cult engenzayo mina ukuze ngi-attain ulwazi oluzongisiza ekwazini uNkulunkulu. Amen. So ileyo nto yokuqala ekade ikhona. Not only did they have a deep history of mysticism where it came from pagan abantu abangakholwa, also they had a deep history of angelic worship. Hallelujah. So the thing about the angelic worship here, bebambiza uMikhayeli, bembiza uMikhayeli uGabriel, bebabiza all of these people esibona eBhayibhelini, angels that we see in the Bible, they were called. They found ancient pottery and amulets ebhaliwe amagama ukuthiwa Mikhayeli sivikele, Gabriel silondoloza, bebhaliwe izinto showing ukuthi they were deeply into angelic worship. Another thing emele esiyibambe lana ekade ikhona in Colossae, selikhona ibandla khona baqala into ebizwa nge-aestheticism manje ngiyaxolisa zonke amagama abukhulunga ngayo kodwa into echazayo aestheticism is umuntu the word means humility. So humility yabo bazalwane they used to express humility with physical means. Ukuthi if mina ngihumble I would go and I'd fast, I would cut myself, I would punish myself, I would beat myself if I've sinned. They would do all of these external works to show humility and would gain them spirituality. So now let's imagine ukuthi wena umzalwane well a new convert coming from this deep history, this deep archaic history. Ukuthi ekhaya bengikhonza othixo bengikholwa futhi ukuthi zikhona ingilosi some of which amagama ayabalwa nasebhayibhelini and futhi kuphuma under ihistory ukuthi uma ufuna ukuzithoba phambi kwaNkulunkulu ubushaya uzilimaza ufaste isikhathi eside ukuze attain uthole some sort of uNkulunkulu or understand uNkulunkulu ngale ndlela. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ukugcina into ayikhona lana ibizwa nge-gnosticism. Gnosticism we already touched it ewonke laba bezimbazana ngiyaxolisa yaphela. Kodwa that ngifunde history and ukubalekile and it's touched here in scripture. So I'm trying ukuthi to cover it so that uma sesingena into the verse we understand exactly ukuthi nomzalwane okade ibhalelwe yena la. Imthinta kanjani le ndaba? So gnosticism bekholwa just uyithinta kancane bekukhona ukuthiwa uNkulunkulu akazange awudala umhlaba. UNkulunkulu wawudala umhlaba ngesidala, if I can put it kanjalo. UNkulunkulu waqala wadala ingilosi ibizwa ngama eons. Lezi ngilosi powerful had some form of God within them. They could do some of the works of God, what distributed his power into the eons. And then after the eons, the eons then rebelled against God, and there was a super eon called Udemiurge. Udemiurge then walanda abanye. Udemiurge walanda abanye ama archons, which were now the evil race. And then uDemiurge kwawuyena owadala lelizwe trying to copy uNkulunkulu walidala izwe ecorrupt yena. So that's why sibona corruption namhlabeni. It makes sense. Sibona corruption namhlabeni ngoba uDemiurge wadala lomhlaba. That's why kunokubi namhlabeni. That's why kuna zonke lezi zinto emhlabeni. Their theology was rich. It says that Gnosticism and that influence I went to so far that even the books, the apocrypha, the rejected books of the Bible, which teach aestheticism, which teach angelic worship, those books were deeply rooted in Gnosticism. The word Gnosticism means it is secret knowledge. It comes from mysticism, so it's secret knowledge. Which when as soon as the person is talking about Gnosticism, as soon as mina ngikhole ukuthi ngimubi, lomhlaba mubi. UNkulunkulu muhle susindisele. There was Gnosticism. It is a secret knowledge in that I am evil, God is good, and there is salvation. Gnosticism is a very clever trick of the devil because it removed a very important component compared to us and yona impela Gnosticism. Ukuthi there was no true foundation in Jesus Christ. So manje wena uhlele umzalwane owase Colossus and I've taken all this information about the Colossus ngoba singabazalwane in today's church we share quite a few similarities ngoba I don't think any one of us here is a Jew. None of us have a Jewish background. None of us know God from a family heritage. Nobody was circumcised on the 8th day as a male and was dedicated in the church, was taken and did a sacrifice, Thanksgiving sacrifice. Nobody grew up with cereal sacrifices, who knows what an amajuba, uthatha manjani, uthi the lamb melibuye kanjani. Ayekho umuntu owaphuma lana owayofunda the 4 books of the law and decreed ukuthi you are a man at a bar mitzvah at 12. None of us qualify to be like any of the other churches which had a Jewish background. If we are to come closer, we can say about the churches which never had a Jesus, a Jewish background preached to them. We are like the church of Ephesus and the church of Colossae, which were quite close together, all in Asia, not knowing God. Churches like that, we can sort of have some similarity with them and understand the wording that was put there for them, because it was written to a level which we ourselves are at. We can also have an understanding. Silbuke lelibandla lase Colossae and sizibone nathi kancane khona ngokuba lelibandla leli had worship, pagan worship. Thina abanye bethu sakhulela under pagan worship. Sakhulela kuhlatshelwa amadlozi emakhaya. Sakhulela kwenziwa imisebenzi, kuncintiswa lokhu, kuthiwa gqum phalaze, konke lokho. Those cultural things that you used to do, those secret knowledges to attain God, we used to do them. That is the Church of Colossae. The Church of Colossae is also similar to us because we do also have some means of salvation which are like Gnosticism. Siyasho ukuthi khona umveli inqangi, wadala konke lokhu. It's similar to them, uDebbie. We share similarities to the Church of Colossae. Some of us we had some sort of religiosity. We find who used to believe in the laws which are written in the Bible, in the Old Testament. That's why they used to believe in the new moons and the old moons and all of these traditions which are found in the Old Testament. This is from a pagan church, and then some people came, it's not written in Utoba, but some people came, started to teach the law of Moses, making a law unto Nababantu Laba, which is addressed here in scripture. So Nababantu was a Colossae, all of these different influences which were there, they had their old cultures, they had this new culture of Judaism, old culture of pagan worship, they had a confusing Gnosticism here on the side, they had the worship of angels here on the side. For an average believer who just came in on a Sunday listening to these people preach, because these things were preached in the church, some people would preach these things every day, and you end up very confused until that figure didn't go with a low point. So, in the ending, at the Ebe Begele Nayo, the Church of Colossae, and his one in Kinga, Esibona Nati, Si Begana Nazo, here in today's church. In terms of religiosity, Bazala, Nati Sinaba, Ama religiosity, Eto, some extra biblical things which have been taught. Like, for example, Kona Bantu, who maybe have come from Ama Mormons, Bane Puglong El Baliwe, El Lochiwe, Nifundi Isai Fundisoza. The same way that they used to come with the book of the laws of Moses, which this book was good, but Ama Mormons, they come with a whole new book, a whole new law. So as a Christian, maybe you're not really sure about your stance in salvation, and you have a Bible, you have these letters, and they have their letters. How do you differentiate and see what is true? Who's right? This is a church which faced confusion. Ibandla ekade ibhekene ne confusion enzima. Amen. So I hope ukuthi sengisipendile isithombe esitshengisayo ukuthi kwakunzima kanjani in the Church of Colossae at that time. And futhi sifana kanjani like the Church of Colossae. So let us read our passage today from verse 16. It says, therefore, let no one pass judgment on you on questions of food and drink, or with regard to a festival or a new moon or Sabbath. These are a shadow of things to come, but the substance belongs to Christ. Let no one disqualify you, insisting on asceticism and angel and worship of angels, going into details about visions, puffed up without reason by a sensuous mind, not holding fast to the head, from whom all the body is nourished, knitted together through the joints and ligaments, and grows with the growth that is from God. If
With Christ you died to the elemental spirits of this world. Then why, as if in the world, do you submit to regulations? Do not handle, do not taste, do not touch. Referring to all things as they were used. According to human precepts and teachings, these have indeed an appearance of wisdom in promoting self-made religion, asceticism, and severity to the body, but they have no value in stopping the indulgence of the flesh. Amen. Amen. Paul doesn't waste any time in this scripture. Paul, in this scripture, directly confronts every single one of these things that is coming us. Ukala with the Jewish law. Ati, this is a shadow of things to come. We find it there for verse number 17. Ati, these things are shadow of things to come. Yes? Addressing that lento irong. But Paul doesn't just leave them and say, uti, lento, yo uti mbambu mteto irong. And we know in scripture, uti ven, and then the keeping of the law does not give us salvation. Jesus Christ in Ephesians chapter 2, he has broken down the wall of separation, and he has brought together the Greek and the non-Greek, and so that all might be in Christ, building up on the foundation of Jesus Christ and the apostles and prophets, growing growing into a rooted in that, and growing into a house of the Lord. So siyazi ukuthi in scripture it is not encouraged in terms of the new moons, the Sabbaths, and all of that. And we see in the other books in the Bible, they go into depth about why. It gives us the reason of why you should not do that. Well, umthetho was there just to point us to Christ. Everything was there to point us to Christ. And we know that that's not the point that I'm trying to bring out today. In terms of moving later, is illa puti, but the substance belongs to Christ.
Yes.
I like how it rejects heresy that. Whoa, but it doesn't go into depth. It bega puti, umthetho lo, puti, inyumunya ikhaza uthini, and it brings you all the way to Christ. It doesn't start and attack the heresy. What it does is it brings you to the central nature of Christ. To understand this deeper, let's just turn the page and go to Colossians chapter 1. Colossians chapter 1. With Christ central. Colossians chapter 1. We read there from verse 15. He's the image of the invisible God. He's the firstborn of all creation. For by him all things were created in heaven and earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things were created through him and for him. And he is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the church, is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, he is the firstborn of death, that in everything he might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of his cross. Christ is central. Christ is central. If you go through the scriptures here in Colossians, there is no way you can miss Christ. But see, from verse 1, chapter 14, it's in him we have redemption. Verse 16, in all things in him were created. Verse 19 says, the fullness of God in him was pleased to dwell. This is really again king about the measure of the Colossians. This is really how confusing it must have been for Abazalwane, Abahlalakhona, Colossians. We can see how their nature and their history and their tradition pulls them back to zonke izinto that is against scripture. But the only answer which we find appropriate, the only theological explanation that is given in Colossians chapter 1 and 2 is in him. In him. In him. But they bring us back to the central nature of Christ. Like we are consoled from verse 22, we are reconciled in his body of flesh. So his salvation came from his body, him, uJesu. In this book, no other theological reasoning is more profoundly expounded on except him. Christ who has made the cornerstone. Christ who has made the body we are sacrificed in. Who Christ who has made the one who reconciles us. Who Christ who? Who Christ who? Who Christ who? It says even chapter 2, it's verse 3. In whom all hidden treasures of wisdom and knowledge directly answer him. What if we believe in mysticism, who should the Gnosticism now isn't? Who believe in what in Oloyago, calling knowledge Tizelo by Tola, even if it might be somehow right, but thinking I call it, it's not in him. That is the problem. That is the answer that was given to an average Christian in an average church with no history, with no understanding, with no teacher, with no pastor, with no Timothy, with no Timothy to preach, with no Paul to preach, with no apostle to guide them, with no elders, with no prophets, with no one. They were given nobody but Christ. Christ they were given. Christ they were painted before him. Also now chapter 2 from verse 1, how great I have a struggle for you and those in the Laodicea, that you have not seen me face to face. We have woman, they have not seen each other. If somebody was reading these letters, somewhere in their mind, because of history, but God just has seen food in what? Some food in what is a pagan, some food in what is a lab, 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 some food in what is a lab. We ask us a prayer that your heart may be encouraged, knit together in love, to reach the full riches of full assurance of understanding the knowledge of God's mystery. These people understanding the knowledge of God's mystery. Is God's mystery Demi Ug? Is God's mystery maybe the eons and the archons? Is God's mystery maybe some other culture which I need to research and hunt for? This is there something more that I need to look for? Is there an answer that I need to get? God, I want to get to heaven and I want to be a true Christian. There is no other answer, it's which is Christ, in whom all knowledge, in whom all treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Christ is packaged to them as the only solution. As the only solution. I'm not fighting against apologetics, which goes, abazalwane abalwisana, who go into philosophy and prove to Jesus appeal. Angilina abazalwane who go into history and research and science and say that the word of God is true in these and these respects, therefore we can believe it. These people add to our faith. They do add to our faith. But to an average believer, you should know how to find the neighborhood Lord, and it's open to the moon. All of these traditions that are working, even if you don't understand it, understand Christ. If you understand Christ, you've understood it all. Because there's all treasures of knowledge and wisdom are in Christ. In Christ, there's no other thing which is given here. Maybe you want authority. You can go there to verse 10. It says, and you've been filled in him who is the head of all rule and authority. I get to learn umzalwane who could stand before the Baba Zalwane. When I'm super apostle, mina Paul, I'm from this. I'm not going to be able to do it. And you should not make the apostle of Christ to some little verse, Colossians chapter 10, put it in Christ, who is the head and rule of all authorities. Put it their authority on now, the authority of my person, Christ.
Yes.
That is simple. They are not given another answer, they are just given Christ. They are not given, they literally had five heresies to fight this church. I'm not sure, maybe Corinthians and more heresies to fight. But we know that this church had five strong heresies, which are addressed just in about nine verses. Yeah, addressed. But outside of that, the rest of the book is Christ. They are given Christ. Short answers to great sins, but great answers to a great Christ. That is how we are taught today in Scripture. We are taught Christ and His central nature. Now, I want to ask you, okay, Christ is central. But I'm not really sure. This in the same way I believe the Scriptures, I have the testimony of the Holy Spirit, I can see fruits of repentance in my life. But am I there? Maybe I need someone to help me connect. Scripture blows that out. Well, it goes back to chapter 2, verse 7. It's Ilana, therefore, you have received Christ Jesus, you have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him, rooted and built up in Him, established in the faith, just as you are taught, abounding in thanksgiving. Yes, so that's the answer that they are given. They are given what? Okay, just as you have received Christ Jesus as Lord, walk in Him. The same Jesus you confessed is the same Jesus who is enough to connect you. You are just as connected as Mzalwane, who has been 50 years in salvation. We are just as connected as Paul himself and the apostles themselves. We are just as connected to Jesus Christ because we come through the same salvation. It is the same salvation that we walk in. It then encourages us. Then be rooted. The answer is not to find someone else, but for you to be rooted. The command is given to you. Do not seek to be rooted. Be rooted. Be built up in Him. Be established in the faith, just as you are taught, and abounding in thanksgiving. Colossians chapter 1, verse 18. It says, He is the head of the body. He is the head of the body, which is the church. So if you are saved and if you are part of the church, Jesus Christ is your head. And you are connected to Him as a body. There is no time where we're going to We never see that. We never see a head that is not firmly connected to the body. You are firmly connected to Christ. You are firmly connected. Point, we'll just go to another book. I wanted to stay in this book. I did not want to reference anything else except for this book. But just for us to assist each other. Ephesians chapter 2. Ephesians chapter 2, you must remember, this is a book that was written at the exact same time as the book of Colossians. It was written in the same time, handed out at the same time, to the same area. Because they were both in Southeast Asia. So, they would have also read them, the Colossians. I'll just read the entire chapter quickly. Not the entire chapter, the entire portion from verse 11. Therefore, remember that at one time, you Gentiles in the flesh, the uncircumcised by what is called circumcision, made by hands, remember that you were at a time separated from Christ, alienated from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers to the covenant of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now in Christ Jesus, you who were once far off, been brought near by the blood of Christ. That is so beautiful. And it says, for He Himself is our peace. He was made one and broken down in His flesh the dividing wall of hostility, abolishing the law of commandments expressed in ordinances, that He might create in Himself a new man in place of the two, so making peace. He might reconcile us to God in one body. We are one body. Through the cross, thereby killing the hostility, He came and preached peace to you who were far off and peace. He came and preached peace to you who were far off and peace to those who were near. For in him you both have access in one spirit, the Father. You are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints of the household of God, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, in which Christ himself is the key cornerstone.
Yes.
I don't think it gets any clearer than that. There is no person in the church of Colossae at that time who would have thought that there is a more doctrinally correct or there's a more spiritually relevant topic in the midst of heresy than Christ. You can go to apologetics to add to it. You can go into research and you can destroy their own, most heresies you can destroy from their own logic. But that is not really what we're called for. We are called to Christ. In him, we have our salvation. In him, we have our foundation. In him. And that is the most important thing. So how do we apply this? How to apply all of this? Siyazi ukuthi usalona ikhanda elindantela lodwa phakathi komzimba. Siyazi ukuthi lo Christ osinikezwe yona oyena uyikho konke. Has all authority, all rule, all questions which you have the answer in Christ. So what do you do with that? I have Christ. Wow, my heart is on fire for Christ. Now what? Now what? What do I do? And I love the way that this book is written. It's just four chapters on my friend and I. It goes into the application in chapter 3. We deal with problems in chapter 2. It just applies in itself in chapter 3. Chapter 3. If then you've been raised with Christ, seek things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. What does that mean? Funda the next verse. Set your minds on the things which are above and not on the things of the earth. For you have died and your life is hidden in Christ, with Christ in God. It is that simple. That is the application. It starts off that. It touches with a topic. On a topic, on a point, it gives a picture of the body. Gives a passage, shows the point, gives you the picture, and now it's giving you the direct practice. It's practice. It's not like this way. Not like this way. Set your heart. Point number one. Set your heart. So if we are setting our hearts on what is above, which is Jesus Christ, that has an opposite. Then we don't set our hearts on prophecies that we receive from people. That is not where our hearts must be set. Don't set our hearts on new books. Don't set our hearts on new revelations. Don't set our hearts on what we are feeling. Any mini into enkulu efika no prophets banbani ezongishintsha impilo yami. We don't move on that. We move on setting our hearts on what is above. We seek the things of above. We seek the things that are above. That is the direct, that's the primary application. So a secondary application, not to foot, was right. Chapter 3, verse 5, it is put to death, therefore, what is earthly in you. If you are setting your heart on what is above, that means you must then sacrifice what is below. Because no man can serve two masters. Put to death sexual immorality, impurity, passions, evil desires, covetousness, which is idolatry, on account of the wrath of God, which is coming. In these you too once walked when you were living in them. But now you must put them all away. Anger, wrath, malice, slander, obscene talk from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have put off the old self and its practices, and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in the knowledge and the image of its creator. It always brings it back to Jesus. Like, just in the image of its creator. It just brings it back to God, brings it back to Jesus. Like, the point that Paul was trying to make is sown in and through all of the scripture. Here there is no Greek or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, But Christ is all in all.
Amen. Amen.
So that's the first primary application. Primary application here also is to put to death. Amen?
Yes.
Amen.
Okay. Calling scripture is skipping. You know, so I'd like to go back. We won't mind. There's something very important I wanted to show here. Oh, verse 19. But in holding fast to the head, from whom the whole body is nourished, knit together through its joints and ligaments, and grows with the growth with the growth that is from God. See, for the Kalen, what this means is that we are the body. We are knitted together as the body. We are not just a body which randomly assembled parts. We are knitted together. God put you in this body. God put you in this body. Therefore, you have no reason to doubt your salvation. You have no reason. If you are truly saved, and you see all these heresies and they start to make you doubt, don't doubt. You are in the body. You are in the body. You are in the body. And this is to the Christian. If you are truly living in sin, let's start there. You can't apply it. I'm in the body. I'm in the body. You are living in sin. Because now it's application for chapter 3, verse 5, Yakshaya, which you are not applying this. Then you must not be in the body. Because you are not looking at things which are above. Yeah, so just a warning there. Okay. Secondary application is merely verse 12. Put then, God chosen ones, holy and beloved, a compassionate heart, kindness, humility, meekness, patience, bearing one another. If one has a complaint against another, forgive each other. For God has forgiven you, you must also forgive. Above all else, put on love, which binds everything in perfect harmony. Okay? And by that time, and let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called into one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing each other in all wisdom, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with thankfulness in our hearts to God. In my house, I learned and spent lots of time just explaining how each point works, but I think the scripture explains it the best for Zalwana. I'm feeling like it's a colony, winning a cool, wearing a food jam affairs, but it's just. But it's true. I could not do anything other than just stick. The instruction was stick to Christ. That's the instruction. Yeah, in the scripture, to stick to Christ.
Yeah.
As a line. And this is a very faithful scripture. In ending off as a line, we started with a confused Christian. With a confused Christian with the reasons why they're confused. With the real evident problems why they're confused. In King Azabu Biz, baby King Azabu. And to the real Christians in the church, who have ever been in this young man, Paul writes one thing, gives them Christ. After he's given them Christ, he then gives them the application to apply, how to apply it, how to grow, how to be a true Christian in the midst of these false Christians. If you were to think back in the picture that is painted here by scripture, it would have been a very interesting time in the church of Colossus. There would be no kibani, no light sighting, or you shall be the man Shozi, and I'll get a sword. Oh, shall be the man Shozi, so to feel in this punch as I can, that I know. You shall be the only Kayan who's on the rocks. But on this side, the heavens are lying, who's put to death their flesh. The heavens are lying, being nourished by God. Yes, he is in the body. The heavens are lying on this side, living your holy life. No one is around with a fellow pants. I know. Verse 23. It's they have no value in stopping the indulgence of the flesh. Inyama yami isangihlula. Isangihlula inyama yami. Ngimhlabela umkhayeni. Ngithatha imesa ngiyisika, ngithatha amakalvasi ngiyishaya nosuku ngenxa yezono engizibonayo empilweni yami. Kodwa there is no stopping the indulgences of my flesh. In this church, we would have seen a radical change. After this book, buzobona abazalwane uhlobo oluthize obelizophila ivangeli. Not debating too much, not spending lots of time with persuasive arguments like they were doing, because they came with persuasive arguments, empty deceit, books, and ordemiug. Such a world of deception. But the only answer was the right Christ and the right life. The right Christ and the right life was the answer to the wrong Jew, to the wrong Christ and the wrong lifestyle. It is the only answer given by Scripture to the confused Christian. They would have left, they would have started with heresies and were lost. They would have met Christ and instead lived in the church with truth and were found. They would have had the Christ of true peace. In the midst of, even in their own church, and godliness in their own church, they would have had true peace. And that's all that Scripture promises us to. As well, Paulus, but into what's in the Zion is O Christ. As James O Christ in the table, Pilanati, and Uganati is your figure, is Pamba May. Unguru to the man drunk, it was for Selena, who was second of me. Was Kumbozo, what ye need a hill, a singing a page away. Was Kumbozo, what if foundation here too, as Jesus Christ is a cornerstone, is testified by the apostles and the prophets. And are being built up as a house. When I've gone away to put his school in a pool, Siba be said a pool, but always to put Siba Melay, who crest, who you call walking. What's in my sister's mammy, they say, Same Pinay, who crest, though you go walking. The same Christ that we accepted was the same Christ that we should be rooted in, walking in every day with thanksgiving in our hearts. When we go to a man drunken, Siba ladies will repent. We've been too focused on fighting, right? Winning arguments, trying to prove ourselves as a better Christian. Instead, we should just hold Christ. Hold Christ and conquer the frustration as it's all and wool and abandon a pantry. Just hold Christ. The frustration as his wife, or what a slide, Basa Tinile, in Tetoyabo, Emden, in Nyaga. Our full moon time to Jesus Christ, they profess to be Christians, but at the same time, Bakabena Mandrosi, they profess to be Christians, but at the same time, Men's Mikuba, Unguletona Mandroke, they profess to be Christians, and they still live in sin, Unguletona Mandroke. To us, you say, let us hold on to Christ. Let that be our peace, Unguletona Mandroke, Sister Puma, you can say. Unga, who is a school, Ukveda, Ahulu, Sazan, Mono Seman, Jesus Christ, we have bosses of Angela. As he went to the local civil Christ, having a mindset of just pleasing Christ. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.